Just rice.
All rice.
It's all rice. Have you seen this much rice in your life?
My goodness, this is like rice heaven.
Good afternoon, guys. David Hoffman here from David's Bin here, coming at you from Edison, New Jersey. Today I'm here with my boy Hippo. And Hippo is the owner of Indian Grocers, the biggest Indian supermarket in Edison, New Jersey. So Hippo, I'm excited. What do you guys do here?
We sell literally anything you can get in India in terms of whatever you want to cook or anything Indian kitchen related, we sell here. Literally, we've had people come in from India saying, oh, we don't get this much variety in India itself. So it's actually a very, very unique place, not just Edison, but in America, kind of.
Awesome. So if you guys don't know about this area, it's one of the biggest Indian populations in the Western Hemisphere, literally this entire area of New Jersey. Lots of Indians, lots of Indian restaurants, Indian business owners, right?
Yes.
And here you guys have ghee, puris. I'm sure you guys have frozen section, also fruits.
Everything. Fruits, vegetables. Until the pandemic, we're getting fresh fruits from India as well, but
awesome.
Pandemic put an end to that for a little bit.
Okay.
But sweets, desserts, we're starting fresh breads, a lot of cool stuff.
Awesome. And how many lanes are there? How many rows?
14 technically, but front and back 14, yeah.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's go inside. Let's see what they got. Follow us. Jason, you ready?
Yeah, let's go, man. I'm so excited.
So Hippo, what do we have here? I mean, it's just like bell mix, just all like chat stuff, right?
All chat stuff, all morning stuff. Like if you start the store, actually, we start off with tea because you start the morning with hot tea in India. So tea, a little bit of what we call nashto, which is anything you can eat with tea, like little trail mixes or spicy mixtures, sweet mixtures, stuff like that. So both sides, you can get stuff that you can eat for breakfast. And not only that, but like even stuff like jaggery we have, which is an Indian version of sugar. It's a more pure version of sugar.
It's actually healthier, right? This is before they make the white sugar, because that goes through another process, right? This is healthier. Over here, we have the same stuff, right? All these different snacks. And over here to the left, we have different paste. You have coconut water. You have Thumbs Up, which is like Coca-Cola, right? Almost the Indian version. You also have Limca. Tried it when I was in DC. And what are these? Just chutneys?
Chutneys for your pails, pani puris, spicy date chutneys, sweet tamarind chutneys, all that stuff.
So what have you tried here?
So I'm interested, is there like an Indian fruits and vegetables that you import?
It's a little out of season now. We don't get that much stuff in the fall, more in the summer. But we'll get stuff like jamuns, which is like a traditional Indian berry. It's almost like a more tart blackberry kind of thing. Mangoes, pomegranates from India, okra from India, a lot of different stuff. And everything else, we still get Indian versions, but just grown in the Dominican or the Nicaraguan region.
Different things for the kitchen.
Heavy use kitchen items. Like if you look over here, we have like massive stock pots, which we'll use for those sambars or in Gujarat, like dals and stuff. But we have a lot of restaurant clients that get those from us as well. So restaurants, temples, so we stock a lot of that stuff for them.
David, look, it has masala pomegranate. What? I've never had this. This is from India?
From India. People in India love masala, spices, so even our sweet drinks will spice it up.
I've never tried that. I love the pomegranate, but with masala, it's a different thing.
Wow.
I might buy this on the way out, for sure. And we have curry leaves. Yes, you have to have curry leaves, especially if you're making Kerala cuisine.
Curry leaves is a big staple. Coriander leaves is a huge staple. Onions, garlic, potatoes, massive.
So where to next?
So next we're gonna do one of the biggest ingredients in India, rice. I've been doing this for 20 years, selling Indian groceries. 20 years ago, you got like four different types of rice in an Indian supermarket, which was basmati, jasmine rice, Swarna Masuri rice, and maybe idli rice. Now you can find maybe 20 different varieties of rice. Now we probably have actually upwards of 30 varieties of rice.
So there's so many different rices. Look at this. You could literally just keep walking through here. It doesn't stop. So rice. We have also here lentils on this side, or
it's
just
all rice.
Just rice.
All rice.
It's all rice.
Have you seen this much rice in your life?
My goodness, this is like rice heaven. Like how many are there?
39 different varieties, and that's just not different brands, just different types of rice. Like 12 or so different brands of rice.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So a lot of rice. Indians love rice.
What is this aisle? What do you have in here?
So over here, if you're ever eating a chapati or a naan, we have flours to make chapatis, naans, parathas. And if you want healthier versions, we have multigrain flours, gluten-free flours.
Obviously, it's not as extensive as the rice section, right? But still lots of different flours.
The next one we can do more Indian junk food, I like to call it. Snacks and namkeens. Okay. Literally, this is from all across India. This is specifically from like the Andhra region, but if you look on the other side, there's more from Punjab and Gujarat.
What's the difference? Because they're all like chat mixes, right? Basically,
yeah.
Quick snacks. Again, guys, this is a little bit like junk food, right? You shouldn't be eating this too often, but in Hindi, you can eat it every day.
We do have healthier versions, but the difference is these are spicy battered peanuts or a muruk, which is again fried batter. And even there, we have different flavors, so they can have a ginger one, a garlic one.
I guess then what's your favorite of all these? Because I like the banana chips.
Yeah.
It's actually one of my favorite things that I had in Kerala, having these, like in Munnar, Thekkady area. Obviously the sev in every single chat, right? Masala chana dal, and then all these are like little bites, right?
For me, if we go at the end of the aisle, there's one called chakri or muruku. That's my favorite.
Muruku?
Muruku, yeah. Deep fried, like spicy batter. It's almost like a chip, which is like this one. What's cool is this one's actually locally made. And that isn't actually. But if you guys drink any of these, they go great with like a cold beer, basically.
Yeah, I'll do a samosa with a beer, dude. Anything fried with a beer. The next aisle, aisle three, is all about the cookies, all about the sweets, right? So what do we have here? Because I just see non-stop biscuits. Oh,
biscuits and sugar. That's all this side is. And if you look on this side, we have more breakfast pastries, kind of like kakras, curries, which is all baked stuff, cakes, cake rusks.
A lot of sugars. That's what India is about, right? Sugar, dairy, sweets.
Sugar, dairy, sweets, and oil. We like to fry a lot of stuff. Typically we're vegetarian, so we can do the frying. This one, it's the most selling cookie in India. Not only in India though, all across the world. Now they're in Brazil, Mexico. So David, we saw a lot of food so far, a lot of junk food. This is more of the healthier stuff that we have in India. Dals, lentils. This is a good like protein replacement for us. We use dals a lot.
Like how many different dals do you have?
Depending on the variety, but yeah, around like 20 different types of lentils.
Have you tried dal?
No, dal, what is that? How does that taste like?
Well, I mean, dal is just lentil, yeah. Right? So lentil, but you know, they do it very differently. And usually you always have dal part of every meal. Okay. It's almost every meal, especially north, right?
If it's not part of like a dal, like dry dish, they'll make like a soup out of it or something like a sambar or something of that sort.
What you had this morning, you had dosa, and that's lentil batter. So they use the dal to make the batter.
Gotcha.
That's why it's a little different from like a, you know, American pancake, right?
There's so many different flours. Like, what do you guys do with this? Is this for different foods?
Yeah, different flours. You can make like a chapati or a flatbread out of them, or something like wheat laddu flour. You can add jaggery, a little bit of sugar, milk, and make like a dessert out of it as well.
So we got lentil, we have flour. I mean, this lane doesn't end. Wow, look at this. So you have these red lentils, beautiful bag.
Wow.
Right?
What does it taste like?
What does it taste like?
Yeah.
You're gonna see today. I know a lot of people that haven't even tried Indian food and they're 40 years old, you know?
Well, I tried like three dishes. They're all good though, but I wanna try more today.
After lentils, we're gonna go into spices real quick. India's a land of spices. Good thing is we also have a lot of ready-made spices too. So if you're trying to cook and you don't know much about Indian cuisine, ready-made packets, all you have to do is add your vegetables, oils, and stuff like that.
Like this, right? Like palak paneer. So this is basically, it tells you exactly how to make. That's it.
Exactly, yeah.
Right?
You just need paneer, maybe a little bit of oil, boiled spinach, and a blender.
Perfect. And if you guys don't know the difference, palak paneer is straight spinach. Saag paneer is with curry leaves, right?
With the
mustard leaves.
Greens, with mustard greens, yeah.
Mustard greens, exactly. Sorry.
Very cool. David knows his stuff.
I'm learning, bro. I'm learning day by day.
In the kitchen, you're going to use a mixture of like cinnamon powder, cardamom powder, chili powder, turmeric powder, and make your own mixture for like a, let's say, chicken tikka masala. I'm not going to know how to do that for myself. So for people like that, we're going to have like our own, like, let's say, chole masala to make our own chole. So I don't have to know how much turmeric powder goes into there, or how much cardamom powder, how much coriander powder goes into there.
Cardamom, teal sesame, okay. Didn't even know that. Okay, awesome. So we have black pepper. This is also referred to in Kerala as black gold.
Really?
Yeah, because this was gold at one point, you know? We have mustard seeds, always part of the Indian cuisine. More mustard seeds, some of them are black, some of them are brown. I guess that's like cooking, or?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And they're all, they can all be big or small. Like in the north, India, they'll use larger mustard seeds, but the smaller ones are more pungent, so they'll use that in the southern cooking.
Okay, awesome.
Next aisle, we can go 2 aisles over. We're gonna see a lot of the more baking necessities, like ghees, oils, the big one's jaggery, which we use in everything.
You're learning, huh?
Yeah, so much to learn.
If you ever had achar at an Indian restaurant, all Indian achars, garlic paste, ginger pastes, which we'll also use in cooking. But right behind David over here, we have oils and ghee galore, whether it's made from buffalo milk, cow milk, I believe we have one from camel milk.
Wow.
Lots of different varieties for that. And even with the cow ghees, there's different types of cows that they use the ghees from, or where the milk comes from. For example, we have a special one called the Gir cow ghee, which is a specific cow in India. They're typically more brighter red cows, but even stuff like that we'll have, which is a very, very rare ghee.
I love the music. You really feel like you're in a different world right now, right?
Exactly, yep.
It's amazing, amazing.
Next, we have the frozen section, which, again, a lot of the stuff we used before was for cooking. If you can't do that, if you're like my wife, kind of, you can use all this stuff where it's just heat and eat.
Heat and eat.
Heat and eat, yeah.
So yeah, this is all paratas over here. Like ton of paratas over here. Samosas, right? And you have coriander chutney, pani puri concentration. So that's basically the pani, right?
Pani puri water, yep.
Mm-hmm. So it's always like spiced water, right? And here we have like potato cheese bites, kachoris, tons of little kachoris, jalapeno pepper. So this is all frozen, just really quick, heat it up. You know, pan, microwave, you know, really easy, right?
So what's your favorite?
My favorite? It's what you drink with beer, samosas. We have a couple of doors down, but you can't beat samosas.
Yeah? Yeah. You never tried it?
I had samosas once with mint chutney, but that's all I remember.
Today you'll have it with tamarind chutney.
Okay.
All right, sweeter. I like the sweetness, dude.
Yeah.
To be honest, I love the coconut chutney. That's like,
really?
For me, the best.
Yeah.
But that's always with like dosa, idli vada. It's more southern, right? And then over here, we also have kitchenware, right? So stuff to make dosas.
It's more like curved pan. It's perfect for cooking a chapati or a paratha, just because it gets to the whole tortilla, kind of.
They had biryani and mutton paneer. I've never had the mutton paneer. This looks pretty good, though.
Yeah, so it's mutter, not mutton.
Mutter.
Yeah, so mutton is lamb, goat, right?
Yeah,
lamb. Something like that, okay? And then over here, we have sambar as well. So this is all frozen, so if you want to just get something really quick, take it home, eat it on the go, you know, it's right here.
So the one we just saw was from Haldiram's, which is actually a famous, famous brand in India. They may be like an Indian version of McDonald's, where they have a lot of cafes all across, specifically the Delhi region. Actually started off as a snack maker, which was in our junk food aisle. All the snacks and namkeens, they were the first ones, and from that they've diversified, and they actually make amazing quality frozen foods now too.
Okay, so we're done with the frozen section, and now we're going to the front where you check out. And we have, wow, what is this, dude? You have like all this religious stuff, huh?
Whether you're Muslim, Buddhist, Hindu, and we have a lot of stuff to celebrate those religions as well. Whether it's agarbattis or different ceremonial powders.
So over there on the wall, we have all the religious items. And over here, we have the kulfis, so the ice cream, right? You have a huge variety, delicious ice creams. We have more of these quick snacks, right? So if you like that stuff, get some. Look at this, he's good. Masala munch. Mm-hmm.
All right, so this is like the Indian ketchup. We'll use it for everything from like noodles to samosas, French fries. But it's very, it doesn't taste like American ketchup. It's very, like the name says, hot and sweet. It's very spicy and sweet at the same time. So it's like a very, very unique flavor that you only get in India for that.
That is it, my friends. Indian grocers here in Edison. What an experience. I mean, so many different products from the continent of India. I love this place. I mean, I should move nearby and just come shop here every day.
Anytime.
Tell me, you guys also sell online, right?
We do. All the variety you see, everything you see inside, we just started a website called shopindianeats.com.
Okay.
It's shopindianeats.com. You can get all that stuff delivered countrywide.
Countrywide?
Countrywide,
so yes. Me and Miami, I can order anything in the store?
Yes.
Online?
Yep.
Perfect. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Next time you come to Edison, New Jersey, definitely come into the supermarket, you know, explore, buy some stuff. You know, obviously they don't have this section yet, the chat section, but you guys are starting that soon, right?
Yes, within one month, so.
Awesome.
Depending on when people see the video, it'll all be up and running, so.
Perfect, so chat section, basically there you can go and have Indian snacks, right? Chats, I love Indian chats. We had a few this morning, so good, but I think it's time to go eat, right?
For sure.
Well, thank you so much,
thank you so
my
much,
man.
David.
Hey, man, a pleasure. God, what an experience, I loved it, I loved
it. Great.
Well, guys, if you enjoyed the video, please give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment below, subscribe to my channel for more awesome travel content. I'll see you in the next travel food adventure in Edison, New Jersey. Peace.